one of the five Greek Orthodox churches in the state of South Carolina, the first, the one to be directed here in Charleston. The church actually began around 1908-1909 with several teenagers, male teenagers leaving Greece, coming to America for various needs of their family. And the intent was to stay here, work out those particular problems, go back to their homes, and get married and raise a family there. Things, however, changed because they fell in love with America. And they stayed here, they went back home, got a girl of their choice, married them, came back here. And they felt the need for a church. So they wrote back to some of their classmates who had gone to the priesthood and asked them to come over and assist them in starting their churches to have Holy Communion, the sacraments, marriage, and baptism. And this is how the church was formed here in Charleston, as well as practically every other town and city in America. So in 1908, this is what happened. And our church was on the corner of Fishburne and Church Street. St. Helens Street. I was looking there for a year. And the ramp now coming down on I-26 has claimed our location there, so we came here to this section here. We are very fortunate. We have a Presbyterian architect, a Baptist builder, and we've got the beautiful Greek Orthodox Church. Mr. Harold Taylor was the architect, and who has studied in Italy, and he knew about the Byzantine architecture. Byzantine is the heritage of the Greek Orthodox Church. That is Byzantine music that you will hear today, Byzantine art you see around, and we're very fortunate for our artwork. We have the amount we have here. The artist was Gondolou, the foremost Byzantine authority in the world, has received citations also from Rome and from the Anglican Church for reviving Christian art. So therefore, this man, however, met with an unfortunate accident, and you see, the church has not been finished, but it will be with the grace of God, the grace of God, and we hope to have the Byzantine art. And therefore, this the architecture is Byzantine architecture, and we are fortunate to have these gentlemen, the very Christian people who actually worked on and gave us. We had in this particular type of architecture was built here in Charleston, the city of culture, and our patriarch, in accordance, told us to do. Therefore, welcome. Our mail corps here was organized back in 1950-51. They were teenagers themselves at that time. Some of the younger boys here were not even existing at that time. And they presented us to a program. Mr. Leon Elizabeth will be directing the choir. And Mr. Tula Carazan, the music, is going to be the organ. We begin with the cherubic hymn. The cherubic hymn is the hymn that begins the sacramental, mystical section of the divine liturgy. Divine liturgy, having been written in the 4th century, is the original Holy Communion service of all Christianity, and it is still retained as it was written back in the 4th century. And in the language of the New Testament language, as the New Testament was being written earlier and the works of the fathers being written in the New Testament Greek, so also was this being written at the same time, and it is still held as it was back in the 4th century. The room again. Thank you. have been presented to the altar, preparing for the consecration, the congregation's praise and purpose of occasion, having already at the beginning of the divine liturgy prayed for the whole world. Now the individual prays for himself, for forgiveness, to be prepared for the consecration of the gifts. And following that, the choir will chant the 143rd Psalm. Lord, I have cried unto thee, receive my prayer as incense before thee, that is chanted every single night of the year. I'm in Lake of Birds Bowl, and the very same song is sung in one of the eight bowls, depending on the week the bowls is to be sung. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, a special hymn that is sung on Palm Sunday. a significant sign during the 40 days after the resurrection of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, being for that is Ascension Day, watch of us before the angel announced to the Holy Mother Mary that her son has been resurrected.
Thank you.
tell the entire story of our Lord's presentation to the temple. Sing, O Isaiah, O Holy Martyr, and glory to Christ our God. All three hymns are chanted together in the Byzantine chant, a cappella, and these three hymns are sung at a marriage ceremony and also at the ordination of a man in the priesthood, as both circle around the altar or the small table that contain the Holy Gospels of Gospels, being married, two joined together in holy matrimony, and the priest being married to the church.
Thank you.
the Greek Orthodox Church in Russia. In order to avoid confusion, it's called Russian Orthodox Church. Has its own music, its own architecture, its own artwork. The culture of Russia is very profound in their church, their music and architecture. This is a sample of their true beginning, as done in the Russian type of music. pride in presenting this program to you, presenting you the traditional music of the Byzantine or the Greek Orthodox Church. Hope that you have been pleased. We'd like to invite you to our services on Sunday mornings that are held at 11 o'clock every Sunday, and see actually the first service ever written for Christian Holy Communion service back in the 4th century. It's retained in the church, and one of the reasons the title Orthodox placed there is that the Orthodox Church, the eastern side of the Christian body, after the year 1054, which is the year of the first break of Christianity, east and west, retained everything that was decided by the entire church, including its services and its religious practices. So the Orthodox Church is proud to present to you what the original Christian church had to offer in the first 1,000 years. Thank you very much. I'd like to invite you also to the Hellenic Center for some Greek refreshments. About 7 or 8 years ago, Thee, Him only,